Okay, in this video, I'm going to use two examples from the textbook to illustrate how to use normal distribution functions in Excel. The first problem is adapted from problem 27 at the end of chapter 11. Let's take a look at this problem. The monthly demand for a product is normally distributed with a mean of 700 units and a standard deviation of 200 units. We would like to answer the following three questions. A. What is the probability that the demand will be greater than 900 units in a given month? B. What is the probability that demand will be between 600 and 800? And C. What is the 95th or 90th or 99th percentile of the demand? Now, let's launch Excel. As you can see over here, I have already prepared some of the basic information to make it more convenient. First, let's fill in the basic information we got from the problem. First of all, the mean of the monthly demand is 700 units. Standard deviation of monthly demand is 200 units. In question A, we are interested in the probability that demand will be greater than 900 units. So here, threshold value 900. And we would like to find the probability that the demand is greater than threshold value. But recall that the cumulative distribution function is defined as less than a threshold value. So here's what we're going to do first. We are going to find the probability that monthly demand is less than a threshold value. And we're going to use the function called norm.dist and the threshold value 900. The mean is 700 and the standard deviation 200. And we want a cumulative distribution function. So that's going to be 1 for the last element and then return. We got a probability of about 84%, but keep in mind this is a probability that the demand is less than 900. We want just the opposite, the probability that demand is more than 900. To get that, it's pretty easy to do. It's going to be equal to 1 minus the probability we got earlier. Here we go. The probability that demand is going to be more than 900 is going to be 15.86%. Alternatively, 900 is equivalent to 900 minus 700 divided by 200, one standard deviation above the mean. And then we can find the probability that it is going to be one standard deviation above the mean. To do that, we're going to do 1 minus norm dot, this time we're going to use standard normal distribution. And z value, like we did earlier, is 1. And of course, it is a cumulative distribution. Return. No surprise, we got the same answer. 15.8607%. In question B, we would like to find the probability that demand will be between 600 and 800. So upper end or upper bound 800, lower bound 600. And we want the probability that demand is between those two numbers. It's going to be equal to norm.dist upper limit mean, standard deviation, and cumulative. And this Excel normal distribution function will give us the probability that demand will be less than 800 units. And we need to subtract the probability that demand will be less than 600. So that's what we're going to do. norm.dist lower bound 600, mean 700, standard deviation 200, and we want a cumulated distribution function. Then hit return. Here we go. We got the probability that the money will be between 600 and 800 is going to be 38.29%. You may wonder why we are looking for probability that the money is greater than 600 but less than 800. Why not probability that the money is greater than or equal to 600 and less than or equal to 800? Here's the situation. Normal distribution is a continuous distribution, so the probability that demand will be exactly equal to 600 or 800 will be zero. So it doesn't make any difference. You want to put down less than 800 or less than or equal to 800. Anyway, you are going to get the same answer. Now let's turn to the last question C of this problem. What is the 95th percentile of the demand? And we can find the 90th or 99th percentile accordingly. Let's use 95th percentile as our example. And here we are going to launch an inverse normal distribution function. norm.inv. The probability we know is 95%. The mean of the distribution is 700. The standard deviation is 200. And then return. So the result we got is 1029. And what it means is that there is a 95% probability that the monthly demand will be less than 1029 units. I recommend that you can try to find the 90th and 99th percentile on your own.